Welcome back. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.
Okay, so I started talking about sections. I started talking about that we have created a section at this location in the building, which you see the result on the left-hand side. And it is going right through the staircase. So there are different types of sections. The first section that we just talked about, this is this one right here, going through right through the short side of the building. It's called a cross section. And another one that would be perpendicular to it, like a cross, perpendicular to it, it's called longitudinal. Okay, so this is the short one is cross section and the long one is longitudinal section. Architects love this kind of stuff. Not so much interior designers. But as you can see, this is one building. It's one big cake, and we're trying to slice it and dice it in a way that will make us understand how the design is put together, right? Without the section, we won't be able to generate drawings like this in order to see how the workflow is going up the staircase. So this is, it's essential to understand how the building is functioning. Okay. So what I'm going to do is because we're talking about sections for the first time, I'm going to delete the section view that we have right here in the browser and start fresh so that you're not missing anything. Okay, so let's just assume we don't have a section. The step one would be to locate a specific location where that section will be taken. Okay, so it would be nice if we could create a reference plane so that we can snap the section to it, right? So we will do the same thing for the horizontal section. We'll go to the architecture menu, ref plane command, and I will simply run a section right through the middle of this. Okay, so apparently we already have a reference plane here, but that's okay. Let's just move it down a little bit. And then what I'm gonna do, you know, I have a reference plane here, and I have another reference plane here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna align them with each other using the align command, okay? So the align command works in this way. You would first click on the item that will not move, and the second click will click on the item that will move. Okay, so this the one we did for the reference plane we created for the fireplace and chimney, is not, we want it to stay there, we don't want it to move anymore, right? So hopefully this was, it doesn't have a name, but it is pinned, which will make it it's not moving anymore. Okay, so we want it to be stay where it is. Great. So now I'm going to use the align command. I'll select the align command, and I'll select the reference plane centered on the fireplace. And I'm going to select this one, and this will put it exactly on top of the other one. Okay, you know, we don't really need to do this, but it's better for the purpose of the lesson. So we have one reference plane going vertical through the staircase. Make sure it's running through this part of the staircase. We have another one running horizontal. We want to also pin this in place. So make sure that the both reference planes are pinned. Okay. So let's get started. So I deleted my section view in the browser, so it's no longer there. I'm gonna create one from scratch. I'll go to the view menu, select the section command, select the elevation command, it's just a section command. And then over here in the type selector, I have three types of sections: building section, wall section, and detail section. So we'll actually create at least one of each, at least, okay? So we will start with the building section, and start our section going from the top to the bottom or from the bottom to the top. Either way is fine. And then you want this, the section has a, let me zoom in. The section has a, it's like a little born baby. It has a head and a tail, right? So you want them to align with the reference plane, and you want them to place the head and the tail in a place where we don't have any dimensions. Okay, so don't put them over here, put them outside or inside. So we're going to pull down, find a place where we can place this. I'm thinking here. No need to mess with the dimensions. Let's put it here. Okay, so you don't want to be close to the building, by the way. You want to be stay away from the building because there is a soffit, right? There's an overhang. So you want to be at least 2 feet outside the soffit. Great. So now that we have that, it's essentially two clicks. So click over here and click over here. These are the two clicks. And then what you will see a view range. So some of you in my comments and on Blackboard, I have indicated that, you know, if you don't see something in the interior elevation, it's because of the view range. So this is the view range. It's this dashed line that is part of every view. Every view has that in one way or another. So you want to make sure that the part you're looking at is inside the view range, otherwise you won't be able to see it. So if you can't see the windows in a distance, that's because the view range is not deep enough, right? So in this case, we want the building, the entire building to be inside the view range. So the including the fireplace, the whole thing. And then we want this to be, don't make it too wide, make it approximately 2 to 3 feet away from the building, from this side. And then approximately 2 or 3 feet away from this building on the other side, regardless of where the tail is. Okay, it doesn't matter. So you want to maintain that distance, right? I'm doing that because I know that some of you are going to have this problem later on because you had the problem with the elevations. So you want to keep your distance away from the building, but not too much. No more than 4 feet, okay? So 2 to 4 feet is fine, but no more. Okay, now the other question is, which side, is the section looking to the right or looking to the left? Obviously it's looking to the right because of where the tip of the arrow is, okay? So now that the section is here, I can look over here in my browser. And lo and behold, we have a new view that we just created. If you click on it, you'll be able to see that view here. So this is what we had before. I just deleted it and did create another one for your convenience. Okay. The first thing I will do when I see this is to go ahead and turn on my medium level of detail. Every view should be medium level of detail, no exception, except large details. This should be fine level of detail. I will make sure it's a hidden line, and I will also make sure we don't need to see this. This is the view range in that we were stretching in the plan view. We can stretch that. We can hide it in the section view. So the easiest way to do this is to select this button right here to hide the crop region right here. Height, crop, region. Boom. Okay. Scale is quarter inch per equal 1 foot. It's fine for now. That can be changed later, but this is what the section look like. If I zoom in on the section, you'll see that in this case, I'm cutting through the window, right? So this is the window. And the thick line, the cutting, the lines where I'm cutting through, which is the wall, show in a thicker line weight than the lines that are in a distance, right? So you should know this. Okay, that's it. This is the section. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a sheet, or already, I mean, already have a sheet called building sections. So we're adding a sheet, make a note to yourself. We're adding sheet I-401 is the new sheet that we're adding to the set. What do we do? We are going to drag and drop this section onto the sheet. And here it is. Okay, it's big, okay? So depending on what you plan to do, if you plan to make a lot of sections, I recommend you change the scale to 1/8 of an inch. So maybe this is what we should do, because we don't want to create to have too many sheets. Let's go ahead and change the scale so I can come over here. And so select it and then change the scale to 1/8 of an inch. 1/8 of an inch. And then so the section now is smaller, and I can use the tail end of the line of the view title to stretch it. As we said, I'm repeating myself, I know, but I want to make sure you guys understand that this is important. You stretch the tail end of the view title so that the tail is twice as long as the text itself, approximately speaking. Okay? And then you can take that and you can move it into location. And then the title needs to be under the building, not here, not over here. We don't want the title to be away from the building. We want it to be under the building, like that. So this is ideally, look at this. Ideally, this is where the building is. This is where the view title should be located. It's approximately twice as long as the text itself, so that it's pleasing to the eye. So get organized. The buzzword for today is get organized. Okay, so, there's one more thing. If you see something like this, where something is on top of something else, stop, take action, okay? So activate the view, right click, activate the view, select the one of the levels, and simply pull out so the text, there's a little gap here between the text and the building, okay? You don't want this to be on top of each other. Okay, so it looks like, okay, in case you have this situation where the text is on top of each other like that, you can come over here, you can click on one of those levels and then find a symbol. It's called the elbow. The elbow symbol looks something like this. Looks like a capital N or capital Z. When you click on that elbow, it will create a jog in the level, so you can separate them from each other. So I'm gonna click on that elbow, and this now is they are separated, and I can use those grips to stretch this as needed to make it, the text readable. Okay? Same thing for this, click on that, on the elbow. Okay, so this is just to be neat. You just, the idea behind this is that you want to get organized, you want to be neat, you don't want text to be overlapping each other. Okay, question, I just noticed something. Anybody can answer this question. Why is this blue? It's a blue bubble and this is a black bubble. Why? So the blue one, as Tess was saying, this is basement level, okay? So over here, is there a basement floor plan? Yes, there is. Here it is. There is a basement partition plan. So this level and this floor plan relate to each other. So there's a floor plan corresponding to the level. But what about this one? Does it have a floor plan? And the answer is no. So we call this an orphan. It doesn't have a floor plan corresponding to it. It's not because it's a copy of it, it's because it doesn't have, we don't have a foundation level, a footing level. It doesn't exist because we deleted it. We deleted the foundation floor plan because we are interior designers. We're not structural engineers. We don't do foundation plans. Okay, so this is the reason for that. So don't be alarmed if you see some levels are blue, some of them are black. The blue has a corresponding floor plan. The black one does not have a corresponding floor plan. It's just a visual feedback for you. All right, very good. So that's how I spend maybe too much time on this, but I just want to make sure you understand what a section view look like. That's a good looking section right there. It's set to medium level of detail, 1/8 inch. The text is not overlapping with the building. The text is a gap between the building and the text. The view title is in the right location. All that good stuff is applied to this. You can even see that we are cutting through the skylight, which is great. It's awesome. All that stuff, okay? Now that we are done with that, I'm gonna simply double click outside the sheet to deactivate the view and then right click zoom to fit. Let's go ahead and finish the command. All right, now that we know how to create sections, so all the remaining sections will be easy, right? I mean, piece of cake. Let's go back to the floor plan and go ahead and create a section along this axis, okay? The horizontal axis. So we'll go to the view menu, click the section command. This will be a building section. We'll go ahead and snap it to the reference plane and snap it to the reference plane. And here it is. Are we going to look to the back or to the front? It probably doesn't matter, but I do want to adjust the size of the view range so it's not too big or too small. Remember the magic distance between the building and the section view range is approximately 2 to 4 feet. So I'm going to drag it back to be about this much. So this is approximately 2 to 4 feet, roughly speaking. Okay, over here, same thing. Okay, this doesn't show really, it's just a virtual line. From the back side, same thing. You know, approximately 2 to 4 feet. Okay. All right, that's it. This will do it. The other thing that I'm looking at right now is a problem. And that is, can you guess what the problem is? What is the problem with this purple line, magenta line? Why does it bother me? Should it bother you just as much as it bothered me? Why does it bother me? It doesn't look to you like it's like a step in the floor? Right? Am I right? Or am I right? Looks like a step in the floor. You can't tell what it is. This is too big. So what we need to do is we need to break it. So how do you break it? You look for that symbol that's over here in the middle, at the midpoint. It looks like this. This is the symbol. It's called the elbow. It's a capital N or capital Z. Find that symbol. Click on it. What that will do, it will separate the head from the tail so that you'll be able to drag it outside the building. This is the head and the tail, same thing, you drag it outside the building. Okay. In other words, if the tail line of the section goes right through the building, it's confusing to the contractor. They don't know where it is. All they need to see, really, is the head and the tail. They don't need to see a line cutting through the building because it's confusing. Same thing for this one. This one. Click on the elbow, pull the line up, pull the line down. That's it. So basically, just to kind of show you what it looks like, all it needs to look like is like this, is an L shape. And we don't want this to touch anything. Don't let it touch, because it's confusing. It's not part of the building. It's a symbol. All right. Let's open this. We go to section two. Open section two. Here's the building. We're going to set it to 1/8 inch scale. Medium level of detail. Turn off the crop region. It looks great. We'll go ahead and put it on a sheet. Let's go back to the sheet ID 401. Drag and drop section two on the sheet. Now, when you place it on the sheet, you want to make sure that it lines up with the other section, right? It's the same building. Not the title, the building needs to line up. There we go, boom. Okay. So you could make it 1/4 inch if you want, but you have to add more sheets. Let's click on that. Let's pull this over here. Pull the view title, pull this back. And now the view title can line up with the other view title. It's okay. It's good that it lines up, but the building needs to line up first, and then you can line up the view title. So same thing, if you have an issue with the thing that's touching, you can activate a view, select the level, pull, and you could do that. You could use the elbow to create a jog here, and then you can click on the lower level, click on the elbow, and then click on the level, and pull. This is the professional way of doing it. If this is too high, you need to bring it down a little bit. No, so you don't want any text to be on top of any other text, right? So we need to have a gap here. Need to have a gap here. Need to have a gap here. Nothing is touching anything, so it's completely readable. And then right click zoom to fit, and then double click to deactivate the view. So I'm going to create a reference plane from the architecture menu, and we're going to let the reference plane go through the door. The garage door. Okay. It doesn't have to be in the middle, you know, it's okay. So we're going to pin that in place and then use the section command. So I'm going to repeat exactly what I just did on all of them, right? So section command, start here, go to here. Okay, this is the tricky part where the section head is too close to the building and the view range is too close. So what do? You can either bring it out or you can bring it down. Either way is fine, but you know, you need to make a decision on that. And then same thing over here. You can bring it back like that, but that doesn't mean the view range needs to be small, right? So the view range, which is the dashed line, has nothing to do with the section head and section tail. The view range needs to be bigger, longer. Wait a minute. Yeah, how come? Oh, here we go. So I was looking at the wrong place. This right here, okay? So find a double triangle grip, and that's the view range. So you wanna pull the view range out approximately 2 to 4 feet outside the building, and then bring this back where it's a good place to put it, right? You need to find a place to put it so it doesn't interfere with the dimensions. Okay, same thing over here. So this is good. Then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click on the elbow to break the head and the tail apart, and then pull. Okay, so now. Now this is the head, this is the tail, And this is the view range, is over here and over here. Is it approximately 2 to 4 feet away? Yes, it is. Let's pull this one out a little bit. Okay, so you want to give yourself ample space, because you never know when something is overhanging from the building. So this, and then over here on the left hand side, is on the right hand side, is that okay? Yes, it's approximately the same. Now we can open that. Now notice that this section that we created earlier, the first one we created, is now labeled. It has this 1/ID 1401. What does that mean? It means it's drawing one on sheet ID 401. That's what it means. If you go to the next one, look at this one. It says 2/ID 401, which means it's the second drawing on sheet ID 401. So just in case I didn't mention before, the Revit will fill out those bubbles automatically for you. So this one, however, this bubble that we just created, this section that we just created, does not have a label because it's not on a sheet yet. So you have to put on a sheet. Now, instead of me going to the browser and double click on it to open, I can double click on the tip of the triangle to open as well. So I can come over here, put my mouse over the triangle, double click on it, and that will open up my section. Okay, same thing. I'm going to make that 1/8 inch. Medium level of detail, right? Remember that story? Hidden line, and then turn off the crop region, and then might as well stretch this over here. Break the level. You need to have a little bit more patience over the next few weeks, okay? Everybody, lots of patience. This is not, you cannot just wing it, okay? So this section shows that the garage is in section with a thick line weight, while the house, the main house in the distance, is not in section. Okay, so this is an interesting part of the building. Let's go back to sheet ID 401. Right click, rename, building section. Add garage. You know, okay, you can look out anything you want, but people need to know where it is at garage, and then simply drag and drop this on the sheet, right? So a lot of what we're doing right now is going to be repeating because we already know the trick. So we're going to I'm going to add one more reference plane. I'm going to add it here at the midpoint of the window. And then I'm going to extend that out, and then I'm going to pin it in place. So make sure you pin your reference points. Okay, so now we will create a similar section, but pay attention, I'll introduce something new, right? I will go to the section view. Building section, click on the reference plane, pull it down, adjust the view range, make sure this is about 2 to 4 feet, this one is about 2 to 4 feet, good. This one is about 2 to 4 feet, okay, use the elbow, the brake, pull up, it's better to pull it all the way, it's better to pull it all the way here so it's not interfering with the dimensions. Okay, you don't want to mess with your dimensions, leave them alone. Same thing over here, put it outside the building. All right, so here's our new section. Open it up. Now remember the story about setting the scale, degree of detail, the hidden line, All that stuff. Remember all that stuff? Okay. Can we do this in a more intelligent way? Okay. So on the first one, we're going to change the scale to a different scale. We'll make it 1/68 of an inch. And we'll make it shaded. On this one, we will change it to 3/4 of an inch. We will make it coarse level of detail, right? Then over here, we'll make it coarse level of detail. We'll make it wireframe, okay? So I just created a big mess. I just created a big mess. So each one of those views is supposed to look exactly the same, but they don't. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna come over here, change one of them, okay? Let's change this one. Medium level of detail, hidden line, turn off the crop region, fix all that stuff, right? And then I may go to the display options and I may add ambient shadows. You can tell by looking at this, it should be obvious to you by now, that the shading for surfaces that are away from you are darker than the surfaces that are closer to you because of the light. Okay, so this adds a little bit of aesthetic beauty to it, which is very pleasant. So this is like a big smile, okay? So this is Tess smiling. Hey, Tess. Did I used to do this stuff 17 years ago? I'm not sure.
Yeah, yes.
I did. I was that crazy. I'm still crazy. Okay. We're creating a view template from the view. So we will fix one view only and then right click, create a view template from the view. And the name of this view template is, let's just call it sections. Sections. That's that simple. Now, keep your eye on these four sections as I apply the U template on all of them at the same time. Okay? So even if I come here and change them to something different, let's make this wireframe. Even if I mess them up, I can come over here, select all four of them with the control button, right click, apply. This is the magic command, right, Tess? Apply view template on these all four views at the same time. Okay, one more time. Right click, apply view template, and I'm going to select sections. We did this before for the interior elevation, but, and then we're going to select sections and then click OK. And sheet 401. We're going to drag and drop. Building section at home theater to here, right? So now we have 1, 2, 3, and 4 views for sheet ID 401. So make a note of that. There we go.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, add a comment, and smash the like button to support this channel. Thanks.